Hello, good evening, good morning, good night, wherever you are in the world. If you're tuning in, it's about time for the final of the FIBA Africa Champions Cup. We are in Luanda, Angola. And that man right there, Lazare Adingono, the Cameroonian who coaches Petro de Luanda, is coming off a sky-high performance last night when his team had to dig really deep to beat Primeiro de Agosto to get into the final and take on the defending champions, Libelo, who, like themselves, Petro, this Libelo team has some very, very good players, many of them Angolan internationals, and it promises to be an outstanding game. I can't wait to see how this one is going to unfold here. Both of these teams have won the games that they've had to win to get into that knockout round and then to win the quarterfinals. Here they are, looking back at the quarterfinals, of course. You had Libelo winning against Bairo Adesba of Cape Verde at 93-61. And you had Petro de Luanda taking on IS Rades of Tunisia, a team that got to the final last year, and they won that game 74-49. Then in the semifinals, it was Libelo winning against Asfar 85-55. And it was Petro winning against Primeiro de Agosto in a real barn burner, having to come through late in the fourth quarter. They fell behind. They were outscored 26-11 in the third quarter, but they regrouped and came back to win that game. So here they are now in the final, getting ready to square off against Libelo, again, the team that won it last year. So who's going to be the star performer? On last night's evidence, you might not want to make any judgments until this game is over, because in the fourth quarter last night, Quezada, who quite simply hadn't really shown up, really came to the fore for this Petro de Luanda team. Lionel Paulo, the Angola international in this team, to the left of your screen, Petro de Luanda, he was terrific yesterday. He could not have played any better. Kane as well was terrific. But Libelo have Olympios Cipriano. They've got some great players in their own right. It's a team with the Moraes brothers, Carlos and Braulio. It's a team that has Eduardo Mingus, a team that really has come here with one thing in mind and one thing only, and that is to go all the way for the second consecutive year. Badalithio Joaquim, you certainly cannot discount his presence underneath the basket. He will be pivotal, one would think, for Libelo tonight. Well, the Libelo, they've got the Libelo have the fans there. You can see a lot of them have shown up, a lot of young fans, in fact, wearing the bright orange T-shirts, and they're going to be rooting for their team tonight. And you've got fans just all over this arena. It's the main event. They didn't pack the house for the third place game where we saw Asfar get on top of Primeiro de Agosto and win and finish third. Rabat from Asfar Rabat de Morocco, but now this is a different situation altogether. This is the game that really matters. This is why these teams have come out, put a lot of hard time, a lot of hard practice hours to try to get to become the kings of Africa. The winner of this game will go down as the best team in Africa, and we know that it's going to be a team from Angola, and that's no surprise. This is the country that is known for having the powerhouse clubs. And don't forget that Angola, over the years, their national team players have been the ones that have represented Africa at FIBA Basketball World Cups and Olympic Games. So it's no surprise that we have a couple of African teams that have made it, a couple of Angolan teams that have made it this far in the competition. Basketball is the number one sport in Angola, and you can feel it tonight with the crowd and with these teams, and the energy is in the house. It's the FIBA Africa Champions Cup, and we're about ready to tip it off. Libolo in the white, and in the dark uniforms will be Petro de Luanda. Well, in the yellow uniform, shall we say, Petro de Luanda, Mani Kazada. And there's the veteran presence as well. It's for both of these teams. Braulio Moraes, the youngster. Coaches will have to make tactical adjustments throughout. Oh, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Luanda, Angola. It's the final of the FIBA African Champions Cup. And Petro de Luanda, who survived a real heavyweight battle last night against Primero de Agosto, wearing the yellow tonight and attacking the basket to your left. And they're going up against the defending champions, Libolo. And Reggie Moore comes right out and knocks down a jump shot. And he will be a big player tonight, make no mistake about it. His contributions will be needed. He started slow the last couple of nights. Now Carlos Moraes hands it over to Valdelicio Joaquim, and the big fella shows his shooting touch. Reggie Moore goes behind the back and kind of loses the ball as he goes up, but a foul has been called on Libolo. I was talking about the veteran presence there of Eduardo Mingus in that Libolo team. But in that starting five for Petro, you've got Moore, Quezada, Leno, Paolo, Bonifacio. And number 23, Jason Kane, played a lot in Germany. He played at the University of Virginia before that. Now he's in Africa playing for Petro de Luanda. You got Reggie Moore, a veteran, an Angola national team player, who makes the free throw. Put his team back in front, both free throws. Now, Valdelicio Joaquin goes right at Kane. He's going to see what he's got. He passes it back outside. It's going to be Cipriano! Olympio Cipriano, and that's what he's all about. He smiles at Leno Paolo. Says, I've got more where that's coming from. Better watch out. Quezada. He's guarded by Braulio Moraes. Quezada gets a lot of rim, bounces out, and Cipriano gets the rebound. Now he passes it across the court over to Carlos Moraes. Into the corner. Braulio Moraes passed up the three, so Carlos will take it. Good! And they look like they've got the wind in their sails early. Carlos Moraes, the AfroBasket MVP back in 2013. And now he puts the pressure on Bonifacio, almost forces the turnover. Reggie Moore, he hits another three. Boy, Reggie Moore has come out feeling it tonight. Somebody get a hand in his face. Adingono telling his guys, let's get the D up now. Mingus now, it's his turn. The veteran, he tries to back up Moore. Turns to his right. Joaquim gets the rebound. He's trapped in the corner. Passes it out. And Quezada got a hand on it. But Carlos Moraes brings it down. Moraes left open. Count it! Well, Carlos Moraes and Reggie Moore look like they've been saving their best for tonight. Both players coming out firing early. Quezada gets it to Kane. And a foul called beforehand. Game has a nice flow to it. Raulio Moraes picks up the foul. And now the scrap down low and the foul called on Valdelicio Joaquim. I'll tell you what, it's obvious with Adingono. You see he's already working up a sweat over there on the sidelines. Reggie Moore, he's feeling it, so he puts it up. He misses, and the ball goes out to Kane. Kane finds Quezada. It was online but short. Now Cipriano. This is where Adingono, his team, earns a living at the defensive end of the floor. And they got pushed around last night in the third quarter, but they really dug in the fourth. They're giving away some looks right now. The outlet pass from Kane to Moore. And Libilo slow getting back, and they pay the price. Paolo goes up. Fouled by Cipriano in a three-point play. Opportunity for Petro. Boy, Libilo very slow to get back. Coach Norberto Almeida, Montero Alves will have to have words because Petro will push the ball up the floor quickly. And Paolo converts the opportunity. Well, there's a lot to like about both of these teams. Valdelicio Joaquim hits the three-pointer. Boy, when you can have a big man step outside and hit the jump shot, it causes a lot of problems. Because you know Petro do not want to send Kane out guarding him. Now Kane, a little bit out of control, drives in. None of his teammates there for the rebound. Nobody went to the basket. Bryce gets in the lane, puts up the little runner. Moore with the rebound. Now Bonifacio. Quezada. Quezada falls down, gives it over to Moore with seven on the shot clock. Moore launches a deep three and misses. And the ball goes off of Mingus. Now Kane gets it. Denied. That's twice. Hey, this Petro team had to expend a lot of energy last night. You almost wonder if they might be a little tired. Valdelicio this time. I'm not sure that was a great shot with no white shirts under the boards. Quezada, he puts up a three. Good! And you know he can ring up a big number. He had 36 in the quarterfinal. And though he didn't play great last night for three quarters, he sure did in money time. And here he is stroking the three. Bonifacio just takes it right away from Braulio Moraes. Hands it off to Quezada. Quezada steps in, banks it in. Look at him, just finds the space. Nobody stepped up to help him after Braulio let him go past him. Quezada. Here with an opportunity to get his team back in front. And makes the second. Wallace has come in and he misses. Well, that was a bullet that was dodged by Petro. He's a good shooter. Cipriano knocks the ball away. Now the pass up ahead to Wallace. And Joaquim did not look like he was ready to catch that. You can see Adingono thought that was a turnover. Watch. And that's a good call. It looked, well, I don't know actually. A close one. I'd have to see it in slow mo. Wallace into the corner. Cipriano. Wallace, uh-oh. You cannot leave him open, folks. He may miss one. He's not going to miss two. And he drills the three. That is a mistake. Probably the best three-point shooter in that Libelo team. Kane for three. That's more like it. Well, both teams seem to be content to leave the other three-point shooters open. Got to get a hand in the face. Mingus for three. And Kane this time called for the foul. He kind of pushed off a little bit with his left arm. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania native. I think that's a tough call on Kane. And it cost him as well. The jump shot from Cipriano. And the ball goes out of bounds. Not good from your guard. This is control. So Libelo with a 21-19 lead right now over Petro de Luanda. Wallace sets the pick. Cipriano gets into the lane. A little bit out of control. Oh, they're going to call the block on Kane. Kane's probably going to have to take a seat. He's got two fouls here in the first quarter. Adingono might leave him out there. Boy, what a first quarter has been. Wallace. Cipriano launches a long three. I think they need to not fall in love with that three-point shot. Quezada pulls up at the line. That's good. Well, he is feeling it right now. Certainly one of the MVPs for Petro in this tournament. A good defense from Quezada almost forces the turnover. The D from Petro causing problems. Well, they find Mingus. What passing. Great patience. And Libelo get it to Valdelithio Joaquim. Just when it looked like Petro were starting to harass Libelo, they solved it with ease. Quezada with 1:15 remaining. Tupelo going back in front by three. Reggie Moore launches a shot from the arc, and it's good. Boy, he is almost unrecognizable from the player that we've seen the last couple of nights. He came out ready, and he has been stroking it. Five on the shot clock in the final minute of the first quarter. Dingus. Now Quezada off and running. Passes to Moore, wide open, but that's off the back of the rim. Bastos challenged. Now Carlos Moraes gets inside and draws the foul. Carlos Moraes, looks as if he caught a finger in the face, finger in the eye perhaps. Watch this. No, I think he was okay. Certainly was a foul, no doubt about it. Rice upset he's not getting free throws. Rice, plenty of time on the shot clock. He goes around Bastos, but then turns it over. And they don't need to rush. Moore, though, is going to take it in. He's going to lay it up and in. There's just enough time now to get off a shot. Will they? And that was a good answer from Petro de Luanda right at the end. And Reggie Moore, with his phenomenal display in the first quarter, has led Petro de Luanda to that early lead. 12 points for Reggie Moore. He's hit a couple of three-pointers. He's 4-6 from the floor overall, 2-2 at the line. And Quezada as well has got 8 points. And right now it's Petro de Luanda on top. Those Libelo fans looking a little sedated right now. Need to stand up and get behind your team, folks. Badalithio Joaquin with 8 points, 7 for Carlos Moraes, and 6 for Lipio Cipriano. Well, 26-24, Petro de Luanda on top. Petro wearing the yellow. And we've got the youngster, Gonsalves, into the game, number 18. He's guarding the ball. He was exciting last night. Watch him. Well, he doesn't play any D that time, and his man goes right around him. Mingus has come into the game, the veteran for Libelo. Now Wallace puts up a three. Badalithio Joaquin crashes the boards, and Doe, the backup there, you see he's got the ball. He was called for the foul. He is a very physical player. Yeah, he got a He got a lot of Mingus, or of Valdelicio Joaquin. Take it easy on that ball. Doha, we got to play with that ball. Valdelicio Joaquin is, this is the first. He really does have a good stroke for a big guy. Makes a second. Played at the University of Hawaii, Rainbow Warrior. He's at the AfroBasket this year in Tunisia, where Angola, he helped Angola to a second place finish. Now Gonsalves gets inside, hands it off. Good move from the youngster. And Bastos drop is fouled by Mingus. Excuse me, by Barros, Milton Barros. So Bastos goes to the line. He bricked it. Joaquin left open, and Bastos with the rebound. Gonsalves for a long three-pointer. And Libolo stepped out of bounds. That was Lewis. Marcus Lewis. Bastos. A little bit out of control. Reggie Morris come back into the game after his breather. Shakes and bakes, puts it up, and folks, he is feeling it. He is like, just give me the rock. He puts it up and in. And sometimes when a player gets in a zone, the way Reggie Moore is right now, you definitely want to give him a touch every time down the floor. So Milton Barros talking to his teammates. Reggie Moore comes back out of the game. Lionel Paolo back in. Wonder why Moore's come out so quickly. It's all about this end of the floor, though, for Petro. They've got to play the D. Joaquin gets in, and that is goaltending. And that is a great call, but it's good effort by Doe to go for the block. It was definitely on the way down over the cylinder. We've seen him. Yeah, great call by the ref. We've seen Doe come up and he really made an incredible block. Now Doe is called for the block on Wallace. And Bastos has to be careful, or excuse me, Bonifacio has to be careful. He went up and tapped him, kind of hit the referee just to say, hey, we didn't like that call. You can see really that of the physicality level in this game. I mean, most of it is being brought, the more physical style of play from Petro in yellow. Now, Carlos Moraes drives in, fouled by Bonifacio. Watch this. Wasn't too bad of a foul. Got a lot of ball on that. This is the final of the FIBA Africa Champions Cup. Asbar beat Primeiro de Agosto in the third place game earlier tonight. And now these two heavyweights are trading blows. Paolo! Well, how in the world? He went right at Lewis and laid it up and in. And now Bastos getting a little bit too rough there. He's been called for an unsportsmanlike. You can't push the man like that. Watch this. I mean, this is not basketball, folks. You cannot. You got to play the ball. Great call by the ref. Rice makes one of two. He'll keep possession since it was an unsportsmanlike. Carlos Moraes will now take a breather and he'll be replaced by Cipriano. And Quezada gets in the open, an opening, and just puts it up and in. Took advantage of that mistake by Wallace, and Quezada almost forced another turnover. This is where you got to watch it with Petro. They will just hound you. Look at Atengono. He's trying to help the referee with the call to say, hey, it went off of his leg. Bounce pass. And the scrap, Reggie Moore. Gets it to Bastos. Now Quezada has it. And he's going to go back to the middle. Over to Bonifacio. It's on line. And it's a three-pointer. And the 19-year-old drills it. I said it last night, and I'll say it again. You need to get this young man in that Angola national team. He can play. And he has got the fans on their feet. Great decision by Quezada. Quezada, meanwhile, playing excellent. Draws the defense, finds the open man. And this is the Petro de Luanda team that is playing with a lot of confidence. Libilo called a timeout, trailing by 7. The shot clock. Mingas took his time and drilled the three-pointer. No, a two was called, not a three. But the Barros gets a hand in the face of Quezada. Good extra effort there from Bastos. Knocks it over. Or Bonifacio gets it over to Moore. Bonifato gets to the lane. The follow from Bonifato or by Gonzalez. Now the shot clock went up, and the question is, did Bonifacio's ball hit the rim? Let's have another look. It was before that. Pass whipped into the corner. And the ball goes over. It's going to remain with Libilo. Violation turns it right back over. Dada, right at Barros, now passes out to Reggie Moore. Gonzalez with the rebound. And Moore has to hustle to keep it in bounds. Now Quezada trapped, passes it back out. Bonifacio goes up against Cipriano, running out of time. They got to launch one. Quezada does not get it off in time. Now quickly up ahead to Cipriano, and he lays it up. That was not a good sequence for Petro de Luanda, and all of a sudden Libilo trailing by just 3 points. Gonzalez wide open, good! Boy, the more you watch him play, you gotta like it. He has got some moxie. This is a tournament where stars are born, the FIBA Africa Champions Cup. Milton Barros over to Mingus. He's open for three. It's good. Well, Petro de Luanda seemed content to allow Mingus space to shoot those jump shots. And Milton Barros claiming he was the victim of being getting a forearm there. Paolo been relatively quiet. They haven't needed his offense yet. Quezada in the lane. Oh, what a play by Quezada! Cipriano outside to Carlos Moraes, and a foul called on Petro for boxing out. Adingono clearly disagrees, as does Quezada. Joaquin misses the free throw. Boy, so much pressure in this game. This major continental title up for grabs. And in some ways, the team that wins this just goes ahead and just takes the pressure off for the rest of the season, because you'll be called the Champions Cup winners. Little Paolo sizes it up, decides to pass back over to Bastos. Now Quezada with five on the shot clock. He launches a three, short. Gonsalves alertly puts it back up, and Moore's there for the offensive rebound and put back. Well, they're doing a good job of hanging in there. And this time, traveling is the call on Milton Barros. That's a good call by the referee, no question. Chance of Petro. Petro ringing out through this arena here in Luanda. Sometimes when a team comes to a tournament like this, like Petro de Luanda, and they just kind of get that feeling in tournament play where they're not going to be denied, that's what they look like right now. They're going to have to beat a very good Libolo team over 40 minutes. Defense from Mingus to force the turnover. Jump shot from the arc. Paolo with the rebound looks up the floor. Quezada. Now he goes around, draws the foul from Cipriano, and unsportsmanlike foul has been called on Cipriano. And Adingono says, that's what I like to see. Because the ruling was that Cipriano was not making a play on the ball. Gotta tell you, it's right on the money. Good call by the ref. Well, he has really done the job tonight, hasn't he, Quezada? Bastos hangs it over, hands it over now. Moore has it. Pump fake, got his man off the ground, tried to get the contact. Almeida left open, Mingus left open. He's out of pulling all the strings, look at him. And Braulio Moraes steps up and commits the foul. But right now, Moore 16 points, Quezada 14. They've got 30 of Petro's 44 points. Quezada's got the ball now, splits the defense. Over to the corner, it's good! Bonifacio! 11 points, the lead. Look at the kids, they're excited. A lot of heads hanging over there on the Livelo bench. They need to pick it up a little bit. D from Petro as play resumes and it goes, and Ming and Valdelithio Joaquim fouled by Lionel Paolo with 9.8 seconds to go. Well, Petro feels like he got a good block. Standpoint, it looked like he might have a case. But there's 9.8 seconds remaining, so Petro, all being well for them, they'll get the ball and get the last shot. Adlithio Joaquim at the line and makes the first one. He's got 13 points, leading Livelo. And did you see? Look at that. That's the MVP right there. That is incredible. How do the players keep their concentration when something like that happens? Reggie Moore gets the rebound. So Valdelithio Joaquim makes one of two. And now a critical mistake. A foul called. And that puts Quezada on the line with a couple seconds left. See if he can take the shots. He's holding his right side. Looks like maybe he did a good good acting job there to get that call. Timeout has been called.
Pedro! Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Rich!
Rich, Rich, stop!
Danny, make it! Make it too! Lionel, você vai ser sozinho lá, rapaz. Ok? Então faz uma falta ofensiva, não precisamos. Agora, quando o Manny marca, fica à frente da bola, só gira. É quando você entregar, com 2 segundos. Aí, todo mundo, o resto do jogador, a bola pode ser passada acima de ti. Tá bem? Se a bola receber a bola, tem que ser a bola de ir, esse merece, ele merece. Tá bem?
Hey, whoever may hit down the ball, you gotta stay up so they don't roll it.
Yes.
So Quezada goes to the line and makes the first one. Now remember, there's 2.3 seconds remaining. The second one is good. Mingus throws it away. Bastos is going to put it up. And that is how it finishes the end of the first half. And Petro de Luanda have really come out yet again with a lot of fire, a real sense of purpose, a lot of self-belief. They are flying right now. They lead it 49-37 at the break against defending champions Libelo. 49-37, Petro de Luanda on top of Libélo, the defending champions here at the FIBA African Champions Cup. We're in Luanda, Angola. And that man right there, Reggie Moore, really got his team off and running, but so did Quezada. And good move to start the game, but Quezada didn't make the layup. And we'll see what kind of fire this team comes out with, the defending champs, Libélo. Well, they're going to leave him open, and he's going to pass up. He's going to give it over to Carlos Moraes. Cipriano is going to float into the lane and miss, and Leonel Paulo with the rebound. Flamingos had the open look, and I guess he just felt like he wanted to get another teammate involved, and Paolo just lost the ball. He's getting ready to go up for a dunk. And now Bonifacio called for the foul as Carlos Moraes falls over. Yeah, he just lost it. Although Valdelicio Joaquim was coming in for a potential block. Now, he would have been a little bit late. So that was 2 points just given away. Braulio Moraes hits the three-pointer. Well, that is just what the doctor ordered for Libelo. Side, kicks it back out to Moore. Moore is in. Earns a trip to the line. Reggie Moore makes the first. So he really came out firing tonight. He's got 16 points, now 17 with that free throw. And 18. Inside, and Mingus doesn't hesitate to put it up from close range. Moore again gets inside and draws the foul. Moore misses the free throw. Tell you what, in basketball, you can get on a run and reel off some points quickly here. Petro know that. They know this game is a long way from being over. Moore makes one of two. Now, Moraes gets into the lane. Passes over to Cipriano for an open three. Reggie Moore with the rebound. This time Bonifacio floats in, looking for a crazy shot. Valdelicio Joaquin and Moraes back outside to Cipriano. People are taking their time. Now to Moraes, he's on target, nope. And foul has been called. Kane basically sat the second quarter. He's out there. Moraes. Braulio Moraes is at the line. And he comes up short for the first one. That was the coach, Roberto Almeida Montero Alves. This is the second, so they said that Braulio Moraes was fouled while shooting the three. And for a player that earns a living shooting the basketball, one of three at the line is not good at all. Good strong move from Kane. Well, if Kane could have dunked that, he would have had a three-point play opportunity. Minga says, hey, I didn't really go hard after it. I just challenged the shot. Kane makes the first. Second one is good as well. Back to an 11-point advantage. Cipriano passes over to Mingus. Now Leonel Paolo brings it up the floor himself. Hands it off to Gazzada. Here comes Showtime from Gazzada. Over to Bonifacio. And Paolo called for the push on the rebound. Carlos Moraes in the lane. Bounce pass by Delicio Joaquim, and he puts it up off the glass and in. Good playmaking there. Kane to Moore. Kane runs baseline. Moore turns, shoots, and scores. Some days, it just seems like the shots fall. And Reggie Moore, that was a tough shot. Cipriano. Now Vasilithio Joaquin back to Cipriano with the shot clock winding down. Good rebounding position from Mingus, but he couldn't bring it in. Now the pass up ahead to Paolo. He gets swatted. Great play by Cipriano. Carlos Moraes drives in, puts it up and in. Great play from Cipriano. Triggers the break and gets his team 2 points. That's a four-point swing. Well, the long jump shot. Petro's fans are roaring away. Here was Gazzada. The previous trip down just stepped up, and you heard the fans get up on their feet. Is this a team that's going to be denied, or will they go all the way? They look pretty good right now. Wallace has checked in. He hits a three-pointer. Well, that was big. They needed that. That gets it back to nine. Kane drives. Four minutes to go in the third quarter, a 9-point lead for Petro de Luanda. Eight on the shot clock. Cipriano gets inside and earns a trip to the line for a potential 3-point play. That's a mismatch. There's no way Reggie Moore is going to be able to move over and stop Cipriano. And he converts. So that makes it 59-53. Quezada puts it up with the left hand and scores. He just went straight at Wallace. Well, we've seen a little bit of everything from Quezada tonight. So it's going to be at least an 8-point lead, but maybe 9, depending on this free throw. And it is indeed going to be 9. 62-53, 3:35 to go in the third. Adingono really telling his guys, let's play some D now. Let's take this game by the scruff of the neck. And Lewis was fouled by Kane. Lewis at the line. Lewis makes just one of two, but Kane failed to rebound. And now, Kane, has he been teed up? Yes, he has. He was talking too much. And that not a good sequence for Kane. I know he's frustrated, but you can't lose it and start shouting at the ref. He also picks up a personal, so that's 4 fouls on Kane. So remember this point in the game, 3:16. Kane gets the tee, picks up his 4th foul. Free throw made. Kane comes out of the contest. And the lesser experienced but very energetic Doe comes in as his replacement. And he's guarding Fadlito Joaquim. Offensive foul called against Primero de Augusto. Slowing down a little bit. Quezada has his pass intercepted. Now Carlos Moraes. Gonsalves has also come into the game, and it doesn't matter. Wallace hits a 3. And Lazare Adingono, I think, has seen enough. He wants the timeout. The momentum shifting towards the defending champions. So how will Petro respond coming out of the timeout? We saw this happen last night. We saw Primero de Augusto kind of seize the momentum and even took the lead. Petro de Luanda were able to get it right back, but it's a new night, and it's also a very good team they're going up against. Quezada puts up a three, misses. Gonsalves challenged for the rebound and kept it alive for his team. Now Doe has it. Will he pass it back out? That would have been the best thing because Wallace went in and stole it. Oh, what a block from Lando Paolo. Game changer. Quezada, bam! What a play. And it all started on the defensive end. Look at the hustle from Paolo. And then at the other end, major play, major sequence. Where Quezada right now is absolutely on fire. And that's got the crowd back into it as well. Carlos Moraes for three. He misses. Quezada gets inside, draws the foul on Mingus. Boy, what a sequence that was. Paolo does it with his hustle and his defense. And then Quezada goes right down and hits the three. He's now got 26 points after that free throw. I think you're probably looking at the MVP if Petro could go ahead and win this game. And he makes another one. Some people do it with the O, some people do it with a D. Now here's Wallace, and he steps right into a three-pointer. Well, that was big. That was huge. Gets it back to a six-point deficit. And then Bonifacio just lost control of it. Bad turnover. Fato's guarding Wallace. Lewis is in the game. Sets the pick. Cipriano for three. Mingus goes up. Bastos takes it away. And then a foul called, I believe, on Paolo as he tries to deny Carlos Moraes. Those two guys play for Angola's national team. And I don't think there's any question that Lionel Paolo was going for the block. Carlos Moraes took exception to the contact to the face. It's a physical game, man. You got to lay it on the line. Reggie Moore is going to come back in. A long way to go in this one, folks. A lot of great players. That's one of them right there, Carlos Moraes. So Carlos Moraes makes the first. Been a quiet night so far for him. He's got 11 points. He's got 6 turnovers. So he's got 6 assists, excuse me. That's not too bad. He's got 1 turnover. Now Gonsalves. Bunga's checked into the game. Here's Moore, puts up a three. And the ball goes out of bounds, back over to Libulo. Divaldo and Bunga getting some big minutes here, and they get it inside, and I think Lewis could have gotten away with a travel, but nevertheless, the shot did not go in. And Petro de Luanda now, they seem to have all the momentum. They had the wind in their sails after the Leo Paolo block and the three-pointer from Quezada. But this Libulo team's not going away. They trail by just 4 points. Well, 67-63, the lead for Petro de Luanda over Libulo. Reggie Moore with 21 points. Quezada with 27. They have done the bulk of the scoring. We got a couple of threes that have fallen for Gonzalez. Five apiece for Leno Paolo and Kane. Kane with four fouls as well as Reggie Moore. He's got four fouls as well as Leno Paolo. So that is an issue that could work against Petro. Cipriano and Carlos Moraes each with 12 points, 15 for Vadelithio Joaquim, 12 for Wallace. And there you see the Champions Cup trophy to the side of the court. That'll go to the winner. Quarter action underway. Lewis over to Carlos Moraes. It's online but short. And now Mingus kicks the ball out of bounds. Quezada almost banked one in. And a foul has been called on Lewis. Side. Quezada. Now Reggie Moore. Mbunga. Oh, that would have been big. Mbunga can't get it to fall. And the drive and the miss from Wallace. The battle for the rebound. And Gonzalez soars in, gets it to his teammate. Oh, what a play from Gonzalez. Hand off to Bonifacio. Look at that. That is a great awareness. And a foul on Bonifacio. side, and Cipriano earns a trip to the line. Cipriano makes the first. Too late with Mingus. Good defense. Ball ends up with Carlos Moraes. Goes in, tries to put it up, but rusts his shot. And Quezada comes away with it. Now an opportunity for Gonsalves. Gets it to Moore. Boy, I bet Carlos Moraes wishes he had that ball back. I'm not sure he took the right decision. Wallace wide open. Bonifacio. 7.5 minutes remaining. Gives it back to Quezada. Three-pointer. And the ball goes back over to Libelo. Too tough, and Gonsalves was there to get it. Now Quezada has it. And a three-pointer is good from Bonifacio. That was massive. Oh, but Wallace goes right down the line. Oh, and he had a chance for a three-point play, but missed the shot. Makes the free throws back to 71-67. And Mbunga open. And Quezada's got it. Bonifacio, another three, and he hits it. So two big three-pointers from Bonifacio. Timeout here for the defending champions. They're on the ropes right now.
Next
So the lead is 77-67. Fascinating encounter. Look at the Petro de Luanda fans, they feel it. 27 points for Quezada, 23 for Moore. 11 very important points from Bonifacio, six of which have just been scored. Well, Cipriano gets inside, draws the foul, gets back to the line. That is what you call veteran leadership. And he drew the foul from Bonifacio, from Gonzalez. 16 points now for Cipriano. Does not convert, but Mbunga was in the line, in the lane too early, I think. So another free throw is going to be awarded. In fact, it wasn't. It was a foul. So Mingus goes to the line. So this could be a four-point trip down the floor. But he makes just one. And Quezada is able to get it before it goes out of bounds. Brianna called for the foul. Ball inbounded to Mbunga. Reggie Moore, he's open. He takes it. He misses. Wallace left wide open. It's just like a layup drill. Nobody got over from Petro de Luanda to stop him, to challenge him. Five points the difference, 77-72. Quezada has it with seven on the shot clock. Mbunga! Big play from the reserve. Looks like he's carrying an injury. Wallace. Could take more here. Cipriano back outside to Valdelicio. Joaquim is left open. Ball goes back to Joaquim and out to Carlos Moraes. 4.5 minutes to go. Cipriano. Cipriano gets inside, scores with ease to a 5-point game. Boy, he is just silky smooth, isn't he? The defending champions of the FIBA Africa Champions Cup, Libelo, wearing the white, taking on Petro de Luanda in the yellow. It's Petro. They've been leading the whole game, but can they hold on? Reggie Moore hands it off to Quezada. He gets it to Bonifacio and, to Gonzalez. And Gonzalez should have shot it. 3:43 remain. Mbunga's limping. Looks like he might have a groin issue. Well, he gave some great minutes. That allows Kane to come back in with the four fouls. Guadalupe Joaquin, that's going to be a charge. He just went too hard at him. Quezada did a good job getting position, and he went over hard. Watch this. Yeah. Got to play with a little bit more control. He saw the mismatch, and his eyes got really big. He's like, I can take the point guard. But Quezada was smart. Called on Carlos Moraes, trying to get a steal, get something in transition here. But instead, he puts Quezada back on the line. And I think in the current circumstances, Petro de Luanda are happy that Quezada is right where he is, the charity stripe. Having a huge game tonight, but just makes one of two. 28 points for Quezada, game high. Wallace, and the ball bounces over the backboard with 3:07 to go. It's the final of the FIBA Africa Champions Cup. The defending champions, Libolo, on the ropes, down 80-74. Kane gets inside, passes back out to a wide open Moore. He's short. And Kane takes it right away from Baudelizio Joaquim. And Baudelizio Joaquim hasn't had the rub of the green the last couple of plays, but now he's got four fouls. And Kane will go to the line. He just kind of fell asleep from behind. Kane just took it. So Valdelithio Joaquim has come out of the game. Mingus is in with Moraes, Carlos Moraes, Wallace, Cipriano, and Lewis. Kane, meanwhile, misses the first free throw. Leonel Paolo's back in with the four fouls. He and Kane each with four fouls. Kane makes one of two. It's a two-possession game when you consider the three-point shot. Adingono asking for defense. Cipriano, Mingus. Well, they did not want Cipriano to attack. They left Mingus open, and Mingus missed. And Petro content to run some time off the clock here. Quezada, no look pass to Kane. He goes up, he misses. The ball hit back outside. Paolo there for the offensive rebound. Kane gets the offensive rebound and wisely brings it back, but they've reset the shot clock to 24. And they let some valuable seconds go off the clock that they shouldn't have. Nevertheless, they've got the ball back finally. Libolo. I think Libolo were to complain. They've had a few extra seconds taken away that shouldn't have. Anyway, the foul by Quezada. So that helps. That puts Almeida, or excuse me, that puts Mingus at the line. Mingus is having a tough night. He's got 8 points, 4 rebounds. one of five from three-point range, and now one of three at the free throw line. And he misses both with 1:35 now remaining. And don't you know that Milton Barros wishes he was out there? The Petro fans making a lot of noise. And inside it goes. Great block, but Paolo gets it back in time. No, it's after the shot clock. And the only thing you could say that was good for Petro de Luanda that time was the fact that they were able to take 24 seconds off the game clock. So timeout has been called. Both teams head to the bench. Almeida Montero Alves, the coach of Libilo, trying to draw up a plan here that'll give his team the victory. I would be tempted just to give it to Cipriano and clear out, let him go to the basket. Petro fans, they can barely stand to watch here. They're nervous. They know they're within touching distance of the title. Inbound the ball, they do, and a foul was called on Leonel Paolo. That's not good. No time runs off the clock. Put him on the line. That is a mental mistake. But Petro won this competition back in 2006. It's their only win. They finished runners up six times. Misses the first. Libilo have won it once. That was last year, of course. Takes the second. Six points the difference. 1:10 remain. Or has it. Content to take some time off the clock. And a foul called. And folks, if you're going to foul earlier. Instead, got about 10 seconds run off the clock. Still, these are going to be pressure free throws. And Moore uses a lot of backboard and rim, but he gets it to roll in. Second one is good, no doubt about it. 25 points for Reggie Moore. timeout has been called. Look at that crowd. They're going nuts. They can sense it. They can feel it. Trailing by eight, this is not a good situation to be in, but I think at some point you've got to start thinking about putting up the three-pointers. And I'm just wondering if they're going to allow them any space to put up threes. Well, he's going to take one. And that's a good strong rebound. Nope. Cipriano couldn't quite hold it. Ball goes out of bounds. Kane was talking about, I was talking to my teammate, not to you, ref. Don't think I'm, I don't want another technical. Carlos Moraes for three. Quezada with the rebound. And a quick foul on Quezada. Long looks on the faces of the Libelo fans. I think Quezada probably is the MVP. Both have gone in. And now the pass intercepted, and that'll do it. And for some reason, another foul committed by Mingus. It's just going to extend the party. The feel-good factor over there on the bench. Of course, Adingono won't be able to relax until the final buzzer. What a game he's having. 30 points. He had 36 in the quarterfinal win. He came up big yesterday in the fourth quarter. Quezada is on fire. And Wallace now launches a three. Bastos gets the long rebound, avoids the foul. And it looks like Petro de Luanda are going to win the FIBA African Champions Cup for the second time in their history, and the first since 2006. Bastos goes in and gets the dunk. Puts an exclamation mark on this wonderful performance. Remember, Petro had to dig deep. They had to come from behind last night to beat Primero de Agosto. And here they are celebrating in front of this huge crowd here in Luanda. They have done what they came to do. They have won the title. They have beaten the defending champions. The party is on in Luanda. Petro de Luanda. Well, it's got to be a proud moment for Lazare Adingono. I mean, if you don't give the MVP to Quezada, you give it to him because they came out and played. You get the sense that they really came out and played for him. He really got them prepared for this tournament. Full marks to that man right there. Also, the Cameroon national team coach and gracious. And victory goes over and tells the opponents they had a good game. Class act. So wonderful, wonderful achievement. Don't forget the big minutes of Mbunga. He came out and gave some vital minutes when Kane got into foul trouble. That's the Champions Cup trophy that's going to be presented. Adingono goes over to Reggie Moore. I tell you, Reggie Moore wasn't at his best the previous two games, but tonight he was a star. 25.6 rebounds. .32 points for Quezada, 13 of 15 at the line. Petro de Luanda win it 89-75. Bonifacio hit those two big threes. Wasn't tonight for Carlos Moraes. Can't win them all. But this will be a tough defeat for him and his teammates to swallow. And a great moment for Adingono. All you can do is come out, give it your best, play hard. And I mean, really, when it comes down to it, folks, you got to get it right on the defensive end, on the rebounding. And if you can add a playmaker like they've got with Quezada and put the pieces around him and play with real fire, real aggression for a lot of the game, you're going to have a chance. This is kind of a celebratory dunk from Bastos. I think Cipriano is like, why are you doing that? We weren't even guarding you. Bastos couldn't resist. Champions Cup trophy will be presented. It was a great night. We're going to let you enjoy these images. And the trophy presentation. One last time, it was Petro de Luanda winning the FIBA Africa Champions Cup 89-75 over the defending champions, Livolo. Thanks for watching, everybody.
mais era esse tempo que o Petro acaba de conquistar.
Me filma também, eu também.
Sou
pro meu pai, me filma, mano. Porque eu tô com o meu pai.
Só que eu não vou dar recorde. Me leva, você não vai. Ei.
Qui a été élu aussi par les journalistes et les entraîneurs, Mendoza, Fidel, Adespa, Paira.
Seu texto foi eleito. É de Cabo Verde, do bairro, da equipa bairro, Mendoza, Fidel.
Au pivot, les entraîneurs et les journalistes ont élu Paulo Lionel, numéro 13, Pedro Atlético de Luanda.
Lionel Paulo foi o eleito, o seu voto ideal.
Merci beaucoup, merci à ces joueurs.
Obrigado a esse grande ciclo inicial.
Nous allons maintenant passer au trophée individuel. Et nous allons commencer par l'équipe Fair Play. The Fair Play Team. Nous allons appeler l'équipe du Kano Pillars du Nigeria. Et nous allons appeler aussi M. Alain Ekra, président émérite de FIBA Afrique, à venir remettre le trophée du Fair Play à Kano Pillars.
A equipa Fair Play foi nomeada a equipa do Kano Pillars da Nigéria. Esse troféu vai ser entregue por o presidente emérito, que é o
à venir remettre le prix du meilleur joueur de la compétition, qui est Emmanuel Quezada,
MVP. Emmanuel Quezada.
Emmanuel Quezada, meilleur joueur de la compétition.
MVP de la compétition, Emmanuel Quezada. Bravo.
Messieurs, dames, nous allons maintenant passer aux médailles. Et nous allons appeler M. Alphonse Pilet à venir remettre la médaille de bronze à l'équipe de l'AS Sport du Maroc.
Le bronze va s'intégrer au président de la FIBA, Alphonse Pilet, à l'équipe du Maroc.
Monsieur Alphonse Pilet, secrétaire général. champion en 2006 et champion en 2015.
Campeão em 2006 e em 2015, mais uma vez conseguiu o Brasil.
Tô puto, né? Então...